city near you is having one of these little festivals.
Yeah, carnival.
Yes, and you go there, they got great food, you can buy the elephant ears. You know, we went to the one in Canton weeks ago, and we saw the Octonauts live.
The sugar water with hints of real lemons.
Yes,
exactly. And they pass off as lemonade.
You can play the games that are impossible to win, and you have to play a buck each time, so you're out $50, and you probably win a toy that's worth $5, or maybe even 3 cents.
You're paying for the entertainment.
Absolutely. So we all go to these things. It's a good summer way to kill some time, right? But not, it shouldn't kill people. And that's exactly what happened in Ohio. And this is crazy.
It's awful, man.
Well, it is. So it's called the Fireball, and it's one of those rides that goes up and down.
It's like
and
a swinging ride that, like, twirls.
So it's like the pirate ship, but you're in your own little area, and that area twirls around. And there's video of this, by the way. You can see it if you go online. It's awful. One guy died, 7 were injured, because the ride the Fireball at the Ohio State Fair fell apart. And there's video seconds before it actually falls apart, and you can see it. You can see it pretty much come away from its structure. And I don't know if the guy who fell, because you can see one guy totally fall out, and then other people were still strapped in. Any way you look at it, it's horrific. And I came in today and we're talking about what we're going to talk about. And Kane's like, listen, we got to mention this. And he's like, every fair I go to, I'm not going on these rides. They scared the hell out of me. And I replied, I have gone on these rides. And up until, this happened, I've never been worried one bit because I've never heard about this stuff really happening. Every now and then, I guess. But usually you don't hear somebody dying.
Oh, this, every time I go to carnival, and I go to a lot of them during the summer, like you said, it's a fun thing to do. You get outside, you know, eat some bad food, walk around. But I never ride those carnival rides. And I love roller coasters. So I'm a Cedar Point guy. But the carnival festival rides is a different story. And I'm not trying to be mean here, but the people operating look like they're homeless people that they just put t-shirts on and said, here, take people's tickets and let them on the ride.
Well, think about it. These rides have to be assembled and then disassembled in a weekend.
Yeah,
and then they hop on wherever they put them and they go to the next city. And Governor John Kasich talked about this and he said, quote, it was a nightmare, but also noted that, quote, accidents happen, close quote. And he said it was inspected not once, not twice, but it was also inspected by a third party, right? And again, if you watch the video, it is eerie. It's so bad. The ride had 4 riders per cart. The piece snapped off. Riders came out of the cart.
As it was swinging up.
Yes. At least 2 people flew through the air at least 20 feet before landing on their backs on the concrete. Now, if you watch the video, there was one guy that is totally separated from the cart. He's on his own, and he's falling, and he's looking up to the sky, and you know he's going to fall either on his head or on his back.
I think there's 2 of them, but yeah. You can't brace yourself for something like that. I mean, it was so scary, and I'm not sure that the guy even reacted, the guy who's running the ride reacted correctly. I guess he hit the panic button right away, which I think stops the ride, but people were mid-air, right. You know yes. What I mean? I don't know if it unlocks belts or whatever.
Well, whatever it does, it should disengage one of the carts.
Exactly.
That's the thing, and could you imagine if you're on this ride and you see this happen? I mean, obviously, it's awful for the people involved, but it's also evolved for everybody that saw it. And the man that was killed, Tyler Jarrell, 18-year-old guy from Columbus, and he was bound for the Marines. I mean, it's so sad. But it does beg the question, it is summertime. These are going on tonight because it is Friday night. Every city, it seems like, these fairs go on, and they have these similar rides. Are you like Kang or are you like me? I never thought twice I would go on. I thought they were safe. Kang, smarter than me, obviously, never thought they were safe, and does not go on these rides at the carnival. 248-539-9797, ticket text 97136. Get to the Lions as well, coming up at 12:30, as we have 3 hot questions about Lions training camp. Let's go to Ryan. You're on the ticket. Hey, Ryan, what's the word, man?
Nothing much. I was wondering why you guys are so afraid of the ride. Doesn't that happen every year?
Does it happen every year? Listen, I'm not saying this is the first time it's ever happened, but, I mean, there's video, and the actual cart, like, came apart from the mechanical device.
I think actually seeing it makes it worse, but something like this happens every year.
So you have no issue? You have no issue, you'll go on all these rides, you'll pay the tickets, whatever the case is?
No issue whatsoever. You're not gonna have a little fun without some danger.
You're telling me that next time you go, you're not gonna have a little fun without some danger? Is that what you said?
Yeah.
All right.
Of course. There's gonna be some risk.
Right. Are you more or less likely, though, to go on a ride like this after this?
Not more or less likely.
You're just the same. So you're not fazed by this at all?
Not fazed at all. We go on those rides every year, every time the carnival comes to town, and we never have a problem.
And the only reason you go on, because in the back of the mind, you might die, and you just said, what's it? You got to have a little fun with a little danger.
Well, that's not in the back of my mind that I'm going to die, but... In the back of my mind, I do know that there is some risk. You don't strap yourself in, you might fall out.
Yeah, Ryan, that's true. But this wasn't a case of not strapping in. This was a case of the whole cart that people were in just fell off. It's amazing.
Oh, yeah, I understand that the ride fell apart.
Yeah.
And I think that's one instance in a million.
All right. I'd rather not be on that instance. It's crazy. I now admit that I now think a little more about it, and I would be a little apprehensive to hop on. And I do wonder how this affects rides throughout the country, because it's a national story. And even though Ohio and the Ohio State Fair, they shut down the rides, I think they might be back up now. But if you're in, and I don't know where the fairs are this weekend, but let's just call out a city, Canton, Plymouth, Northfield, whatever. If you come across one of these rides, you letting your kid go on it? You going on it?
Are you going to let, like, I know Olive is really young, but they have those, like, really little kid rides, you know, they kind of go, like, what, 10 feet off the ground, maybe, and, like, in a little, you know, Ferris wheel, whatever. You concerned about those things at all because of this? Or
I'll tell
is
you what,
just an overreaction?
The Comerica Park Ferris wheel, super safe. Super safe. When I went on it with Olive, when I went to a Tiger game, and it was... so scary.
What?
It was. Because, you know, you get stopped up on top, right? And there's not really seatbelts. You're not going to fall out unless you have a kid that jumps out. So you're not going to fall out. It was so scary for me, though. I literally bear hugged Olive until it was done. The ride is so safe, and it was very fun. But I don't think I was ready for that. So I don't think Olive gets to go on anything until she can make her own decisions. Couple quick ticket texts. Carney rides are unsafe. Who would have thunk it? Just for an example.
That's what I always think.
Hey, Jeff, go to Wikipedia, put in amusement park accident, your mind will be blown. I guarantee you, you will never step foot on another ride, and I'm sure you will never let your daughter do the same thing when she gets old, Jane Canton. It was at the Ohio State Fair, you moron, not a small town carnival.
Doesn't matter. All those places have the same type of ride, whether
right,
it's
exactly.
A lot of them or just a few of them.
Right. Back when they used to do the Michigan State Fair, same type of rides. They're not like rides. Listen, there's two kinds of rides. There's the big structures at Cedar Point that never go anywhere.
Roller coasters.
Yes, they close them down for the winter, but they're still there, right? And then there's these that they put in some warehouse somewhere, and they build, and then they take apart, and they build again wherever they get to their next destination. So don't call me a moron. I'm a moron about a lot of things. But there's two different kind of rides, moron.
Hey, by the way, that was a rip, him calling you a moron.
Oh, that was negative. It's negative. And then one more for you. Imlay City has a fair this weekend. They have that same ride going strong, even though the manufacturer put out a statement to cease using them. Scary Josh and Flint. Is that true? Before we read that, we might want to find out if that's accurate. One more for you. I work for a carnival travel and working there, and it is unreal how rigged they are when you go. Imagine building and tearing it down 500 times, how much stuff you would lose both trunk size. It's really bad.
That's a great point. See what I'm saying?
Wow. So what he's saying is that you build up the machine, then you take it apart, and you might lose a bolt.
But you're on to the next city.
Right, we'll get one. Show can't stop. We'll get one that looks like it. Wow. I'm out.
Or you might not even notice. I don't know how they do these things. I don't know what kind of training they have to go through.
I'm saving my tickets for like Octonauts Live. 97 on the ticket.
When you're looking for a new or pre-owned car, be informed and choose wisely. Don't buy just any old used car when you can drive a like-new certified pre-owned Cadillac from Genesis Cadillac. certified pre-owned Cadillac will look and feel like a new car. Only you will know the difference. The savings is yours, along with a factory backed warranty and roadside assistance. Visit GenesisCadillac.com or stop in 9 Mile and I-94. You're going places, and Genesis Cadillac will take you there.
I'm Brian from 1-800-GOT-JUNK.
Fred looks 20 years younger.
Fred?
My next door neighbor. You guys were there yesterday.
You wanted to wear my hat.
20 years younger.
All you have to do is point, and whatever you're pointing at will disappear.
Let's get rid of that, and that, and that.
Will there be anything else?
I feel amazing.
Fantastic segment. State Fair had that ride, the Fireball, not Sully's favorite shot, but the actual ride. It broke apart in midair. Guy dies, 7 injured. And Kane, listen, I'll give Kane credit. Kane from the get-go says, I never go on these things. I always worry about these things. I'm a dumbass. I never worry about these things. I always go on them. Now my opinion might be changed. Now, we did get the one guy that said, hey, listen, check Wikipedia. There's a ton of instances that this happens all the time. And I believe him, and I didn't check it yet, but I will. But I'm just curious. Does this affect you going on these rides at carnivals coming near you? Because it's this weekend. It's next weekend. It's the weekend after that. It's every weekend during the summer. And they start on Fridays and Thursdays. So 248-539-9797. Some quick ticket text. Just went to the Clawson Fair. Rides had to be from the 1970s. I was scared to let my kids ride. Seriously. Whitmer. Come on, Riggs. We don't stop flying because an airplane goes down somewhere. That's more likely than a carny ride falling apart, Jeff and Romulus. There's a difference. Airplanes are kind of, unless you're John Madden, you have the bus. Airplanes are needed. They're a necessity. They're what you have to go through, unfortunately. You don't have to go on one of these rides. Like, it's not like you're going to walk away and say, that was worth the 7 tickets. When rides are put together by a bunch of wacky carnies, I'm not getting on them. Things to me and worth my life, especially when you know, don't know if they were drunk or high when putting it together right in Marine City. To be fair, I know the carnies don't look good. I just got ripped out for my apparel today. But listen, guys don't care what they wear. However, these are checked by a third party. Okay? So the carnies put it together, yes. But it's also checked by an official at that fair, from my understanding. Jeff, I would never get on a carny ride, but would have no problem with Cedar Point. Jim, of course, yeah.
Cedar Point. I'm the same way with that one, too. I had no real fear when I go to Cedar Point, except for the genuine fear that comes when you're up high. But on a falling out of it, not really. Cedar Point's a different story for me. Carnival rides.
Like, but this has happened in, like, Six Flags.
Yeah,
this has happened at the big amusement parks, too.
Yeah.
Listen, it's gonna, like, John Kasich, I thought it was kind of insensitive, but he did have a quote in the CNN article that I read, and if I can find it, he essentially said, this is horrible when accidents happen. I mean, it's the truth. It's got a Sean, you're on the ticket. Hey, Sean, what's up, man?
How you doing?
Hey, dude. What's the word?
Well, I look at it like this. You get in your car every day, and there's an accident when you're going to work every day. Cars flipped over, roll over, and we still choose to drive. We don't think twice about it. I mean, you never think that you're going to drive around the corner and somebody's going to cheat on you at 100 miles an hour.
Sean, listen, you're right. I mean, you probably have the highest percentage to die on a given day during a car crash. I would agree, and that's the one thing you do most commonly. However, it's kind of like the airplane. You have to get in the cars for the most part, unless you want to get a bus pass, or unless you're, like,
I mean,
even if you're in Uber.
You can still get injured on the bus, too. But what I'm saying is, it's a mechanical machine that's being built by people, and people in these auto plants are high and drunk, putting your cars together, missing screws, leaving alcohol bottles inside the door panels. I know somebody who...
just can't swear. Did you believe that, by the way? Guy puts together his car on the assembly line, and there's a 40 bottle in there, or there's a bottle of, I don't know, a nice Chardonnay?
I've read stories like that before.
Yeah.
It's not the most, you know, assuring thing to hear.
I live in Imlay City. I've been seeing that ride go in strong all week. I work with a former carny. This guy tells me the craziest stories about people drinking and doing drugs all night long before assembling those rides. He used to operate one.